It's me again. So in the last two videos, we looked at how full-scale racing cars have taken aerodynamic design into account, as well as how the 8-scale off-road industry has taken it into account in the last 30 years. So now, in this third part of this aerodynamic series, I would like to conclude what we found and sort of paint away what aerodynamic design can look like in the future in 8-scale off-road and what we probably should do at the moment. So to start out with, we have to take some things into account. And the main two things I think we need to focus on is the fact that we have wheels that are spinning that create a huge amount of turbulence, and also the fact that our front end design of our 8-scale cars isn't very aerodynamic. The huge shocks in the front and the huge shock tower don't really make for the perfect aerodynamic design. They create a huge amount of drag and turbulence, and it makes our job designing the car in an aerodynamic way really, really difficult. So we want to try to design some features that could minimize the downsides to these two issues we have, and also we want to create a design that can work around these two things. Okay, so now we can go to what we actually need to do. The way I like to think about aerodynamic design in 8-scale off-road is divided into three parts. The first part is the body shell, the second part is the rear wing, and the third part is pretty much everything else. So front scoops, upper arm wings, shark fins, anything you can think of. So let's start out by all the extra stuff. Upper arm wings, front scoops, all of that. So recently there's been a huge popularity rise in the front upper arm wings. These put a lot of downforce straight onto the tire as it's attached to unsprung mass. This can work in your favor a lot of the times, but also this is not that good for bumpier tracks as that downforce is in unsprung mass. Either way, this is a good way to generate a lot of more downforce than you would have if you would attach these wings to sprung mass. I personally haven't enjoyed the front upper arm wings that much, as the front end is pushed down quite a lot, and it really makes the car handle a lot worse over bumps. I think with the setup that has the car understeer a little bit, these wings can definitely make your car have that little edge in the front that you can make the car steer better, but it can also really hurt you when the track is bumpy. Then the front scoops. In my opinion, these aren't a huge deal. They don't really provide anything too significant. I bet they do something in the front, but if you forget to put it on, I don't think you're gonna have any troubles. Then the shark fins. These were popular with the Proline Predator as well as the Bulldog bodies, but I don't think these ever really worked. The reason why these don't really work in 8-scale off-road is that the cars slide quite a lot, and if you attach a shark fin, this reduces the slide of the car. So if you drive the car in a way that you want the rear end to slide, this would work against that sliding motion, and most of the time it would lose steering quite a lot. But still, the stability increase this would give is not that significant in my opinion. Now, concluding this extra winglet segment, I would like to say that to me, the shark fins and the upper arm wings most likely will work in some scenarios, but in other scenarios they can really work against you as well. So you really have to know what you're doing. You can't just put them on and think they'll work every time. What comes to the front scoops, then I don't really care. You can put that on, put that off. I don't think you're gonna notice a major difference. It might help you sometimes, but it most likely be more mental than actually helping you on the track. Then let's go to the rear wing. There's never really been that much difference in the rear wing design. After all, the Kyosho wing has been the standard of the industry for the last 10 years, and in recent years there's been some variations of it. But in reality, the wings we have at the moment all look very similar and have almost all the same characteristics on them. The reason behind this is the fact that the rules create certain dimensions for the wings, and we are pretty much maxed out on every dimension. this results in the fact that there isn't much you can do with the wing design that would be totally different. Now, some wings have a gurney flap, some wings have slightly larger end plates, and some wings have slightly different design for the second element on the wing. But mostly, these changes are very minor. And the biggest differences in these wings you're probably going to see are the weight difference you have with some of these wings. Now, the gurney flap definitely makes a slight difference. This isn't the major difference. In most scenarios, I prefer to run without it, but definitely there's some use to it if you really enjoy having that rear grip at all times. But again, it's not a major difference, it's just a slight adjustment. Now, is there a way to make these wings different? I think yes. As we did in the last episode, we looked at the WRC wing in the Toyota Yaris. You have the side of the wing that's angled so that when you would slide the car, it would actually also have downforce. Now, all wings have straight end plates. What this does is when you would slide the car, these generate a drag on the slide, so you would have less slide. But what we would ideally want is to have downforce when we would slide the car. Now, it could be possible to make the side of the wing so that it would generate downforce as you would slide the car, but I think the issue with this is the dimensions of the wings are quite narrow, and that would result in the fact that you would lose some of the width of the wing in the process because you have to angle the sides. That would obviously then lose you some of the downforce of the wing. But I still think there's a chance to make it work, and I think there's definitely a potential in thinking about this in A-scale off-road. Alright, now to the main thing, the bodyshell. So, there are a few type of designs that I think are very good and should be the main focus going forwards. My favorite body to look at is the J-Concepts S15. This has a really capped forward design, so you have a lot of downforce in the front of the car. And you have these side winglets that provide some downforce on the side as well as guide the air up to the, towards the wing. Now, I don't think this body is optimal. I think you can create a much better body aerodynamic wise, but I think this body provides a really good base and I think it shows with how much people use this body shell. Now, I think the principles this body has being created behind are the right principles, which is creating downforce in the front with the cab and then creating maximum downforce with the wings in the side. But I still think there's some issues in this body. One for being the side wings could be much bigger and they should be much bigger. And I also think the front windshield should be at a less aggressive angle, just because we could then create more airflow around the car instead of having that much drag in the front and creating that turbulent air. One of my absolute favorite designs is the Wernemann body, because he thought outside of the box at the time, which is, at that time, the bodies never had those side wings on it, and also he attached some side dams to the body so that the air would be captured in the side of the car instead of just flowing around the car. But then I also think he made some very critical errors that isn't beneficial to the body. First mistake he made, he put the side wings too far back, and as I said in the last video, this decreases stability and also decreases steering. And also, another mistake he made with the body is in the front, he made some side dams around the windshield. Now, this is something that would seem to work great if we weren't sliding the car, but as we went through a number of times in this video already, we slide the car quite a lot, and we have to take that into account when we are designing these bodies and wings and everything. It captures the airflow between these side dams and towards the windshield, and when you would slide the car or go into a turn, the airflow would be coming at an angle. What this would then do is not make the car steer as well, because the air wouldn't want to go at an angle to the windshield, it would want to be captured between the side dams. I've tried this, I created some similar design with Lexan, and what it did, it made my car push a lot more, but it still made the front end slightly more dominant, so the car was really unprecise and the front end wasn't as free as I would like it to be. Also, one thing, a lot of the body design doesn't take into account is guiding air towards the rear wing. With the body, we can really create airflow from the body to the wing. These side wings do exactly that, and that's why I'm such a huge fan of them. And I really love to see that. I think the Mugen body has them now, the S15 has them now, and a lot more brands are probably creating bodies that have them now. I really like the fact that these are becoming a standard in the 8-scale industry. Now let's get back to those issues we started out with. The front end isn't aerodynamic at all, and the tires create a lot of turbulence. Now, what we could do about the tire turbulence, we could create some wings on the side of the body. This wouldn't look very good, but I think this would help quite a lot with the rear tires especially. You really can't do much for the wheels in the front, but at least we can do something in the rear. Then what comes to the front aerodynamic design, I think Kyosho has taken this into account more than other brands. They have the wide opening between the front shock tower, and I think this type of design reduces a lot of the downsides that we have in the current design of the front end of our cars. It wouldn't help all of them, but with this type of design, if you would attach the front scoop, I would then believe the benefit of the front scoop would be much bigger than what it is at the moment. Now, one thing some people have thought about previously, and I think David Ongaro at the one point ran a front wing in his car. This is very popular in 2-wheel drive 10 scale, but in 8 scale the issue is that these break quite often, and the benefit of this is not that huge. I think the main thing is creating a body that creates a good amount of downforce and really gets the most out of the airflow that goes around the car. Now, pretty much I've said some ideas that could be done, but I read through the FA rule books and I couldn't find any real rules around the body design or any extra winglet designs. The rear wing has quite strict restrictions, but pretty much anything else goes. So if you really want to do something crazy, like create huge side swings to the rear to guide air over the rear tires, or create a huge front wing, or anything you would really think of, it's legal. There's no rules banning it at the moment. So creating some crazy aero designs don't have a huge benefit. In the end, if you're gonna put winglets in every single point of the car, most likely you're not gonna gain much, but you'll work on it way more than you probably should. But I think you could still gain something out of this, and as there's no rules banning it, I think there's a good chance of trying something out. So I personally want to try something out next time once we get back to running. I have a few ideas in mind, and then I'll do more videos about it. But for now, I'll end on this. I hope you enjoyed these videos around aerodynamics and maybe learned something new in the run as well. Anyway, until next time. Alright, I hope you liked that video. If indeed I did actually help you out, please let me know by writing a comment down below. Also, if you like my type of content, feel free to like my Facebook page as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also share it with your friends in social media. Now, if you think I was wrong about something in this video, please let me know. I'll go through all the comments, and I'm really open to differing opinions, and I really want to just spark up a conversation. So with all that, until next time.